Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at how to determine aromaticity when we have a charge in our molecule. So remember, to start out with, before I can even consider if something is aromatic or not, I have to have three requirements met. The molecule has to be cyclic, it has to be conjugated throughout, so every atom has to have a p orbital on it, so that basically you could do resonance all the way around that cyclic system. And lastly, it has to be planar. And if all of those requirements are met, then we can count the number of electrons in our system and see if we have an aromatic or an anti-aromatic compound. So this molecule is cyclic, and if we assume that it's planar, the last thing we need to check is that it's conjugated. So if we think about what a carbocation is, it's a carbon that has three bonds and no lone pairs of electrons, and so it's positively charged, and it has on it an empty p orbital. So that carbocation is completing the conjugation around that cyclic system. The other thing I could do just to sort of test out my theory here is if I can push electrons around the ring and towards that charge, or push that charge around the ring all the way around, then it's a conjugated system throughout. So looking at our molecule then, we can count electrons to figure out if this is an aromatic or an anti-aromatic compound. So I have 1, 2, 3 pi bonds, right, in this molecule. And each of those pi bonds is going to have 2 electrons, so that's 6 total electrons. And then I also have this carbocation, but that doesn't have any electrons associated with it. It completes the conjugation around the system, but it doesn't contribute any electrons to the pi system. So my number of electrons is 6, and 4 times 1 plus 2 is equal to 6, so this is an aromatic compound. So now let's look at an example where we have a negative charge. So this molecule is cyclic, right? And we're trying to determine if it is conjugated throughout. And then the last thing is that in order for it to be aromatic or anti-aromatic, it would have to be planar, okay? And in order for it to be planar, the hybridization of the atom with that negative charge on it would have to be sp2 hybridized. So the lone pair of electrons in this case is in an unhybridized p orbital, and that would make the entire system planar. So when a charge can participate in resonance, it has to be in an sp2 hybridized carbon because it has to be in this p orbital like this. So that negatively charged carbon, which would be make it an anion, so that's what we would say for a negative charge, is going to be contributing to the conjugation of the entire molecule. So then again, we can count electrons. So we have 1, 2, 3 pi bonds again, right? And we said there's 2 electrons in each pi bond, and so that's going to be 6 electrons there. The other thing we have is a negative charge. So we have a lone pair of electrons, so there's 2 electrons also. That's from our lone pair of electrons, for a total of 8 electrons. And 8 is going to be 4N rule. So 4 times 2 is 8 electrons. This molecule is anti-aromatic. So a molecule that has a charge and is not neutral can be aromatic or anti-aromatic. It just depends on the number of electrons in the pi system. So a carbocation, like in the previous example, would complete conjugation but not contribute any electrons to our pi system. And then a carbanion would contribute a lone pair of electrons to the pi system, so you'd have 2 that you'd add from that lone pair. So the combination of those charges with any pi bonds or other lone pairs of electrons that might be in that system will give you your total electron count, and then you can either use 4N plus 2 or 4N to figure out if the molecule is aromatic or anti-aromatic. So this has been a look at how to analyze molecules that have a charge. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends.